Good morning, my dear students. Welcome for today's video lecture of Maths. In today's lecture, we are going to learn the concept comparison of fraction. When we learn the numbers, we learn to compare the different numbers and the numbers of 7-digit, 8-digit or 9-digit. Comparison means what? Deciding, determining the numbers which are greater or which are smaller, okay? Or we arrange the number into ascending and descending order. So that was comparison of our normal numbers. Okay. Today here we are going to learn to compare fraction. You know, we can compare fraction also. If you are given 1 by 2, 4 by 5, we can compare these. Okay. So how to compare which out of these, which fraction is greater, which fraction is smaller? That we can decide, but how to do that? Okay, so that we are going to do here. This is the first part we can say. In these, we are going to learn two types of comparison. Comparison of fraction when its denominators are same, when different fractions are given having same denominator. How to compare that? And when numerators are different, comparison of fraction when their numerators are same. Okay, when denominators are same and when numerators are same. So in these two conditions, how to compare the fractions, that we are going to learn today. See here, first we see when denominators are same. So what is this concept, denominators are same? See here, let's take one example. So this is one chocolate, we can say. This chocolate, let's divide into 8 parts. 8 equal parts, okay? So consider these are 8 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Suppose these are 8 equal parts. So, and out of these 8 equal parts, three parts are shaded, okay? So the fraction for the shaded part, shaded chocolate, we can say is what? How can you represent this in the form of fraction? 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, total equal parts will write down and shaded part all. Oh, right. So the fraction for this chocolate is 3 8. Fraction for the shaded chocolate is 8 3 8, okay? Now similarly, there is same chocolate, there is another same chocolate, again it is divided into 8 equal parts, but this time how many parts are shaded? 2 parts are shaded. How many parts are shaded? 2 parts are shaded. So this can be represented by 2 by 8, right? Out of 8, 2 are shaded. Okay. Let's take one more chocolate. All these chocolates are same, huh? Same in size, same in cost, same in size. Okay. Again, this is divided into 8 equal parts. Okay, and this time how many parts are shaded? 4 parts are shaded. How many parts are shaded? 4 parts are shaded. Okay, one more will take. 5 parts are shaded. Okay, so the fraction for the shaded part is 5 by 8. That is 8 equal parts and above the bar shaded parts 5. Fine. Let's take one more chocolate. So many chocolates, right? Eight equal parts and this time only one part is shaded. Okay, so the fraction of all this is 1 by 8. Now we have 4 fractions: 3 by 8, 2 by 8, 5 by 8, 1 by 8. 3 by 8, 2 by 8, or 2 upon 8, 5 upon 8, and 1 upon 8. Okay? These fractions are there. Now, here see, if you observe this fraction, their denominators are same. Their denominators are same as we have the condition. Comparison of fraction when denominators are same. So, these fractions have denominators same. 8, 8, 8. Right? Okay, so we have to arrange them into ascending order or descending order. Means we have to compare which is smaller, greater than that, and the greatest one. Okay, so what we do, we'll arrange them into ascending order, smallest to biggest. So in this, can you tell me which is smallest out of these four? Which is the smallest fraction? Yes, you can tell, because why? See here, same chocolates are there, same equal parts are there, 8, 8, right? And see now, if you see the shaded portion, in these, in which chocolate the shaded portion is the smallest? In which chocolate? Yes, in this fourth one. Only one out of 8 equal parts. Only one part is shaded, right? So this portion is smallest. If you observe the shaded portion here, this part is the smallest, okay? So the fraction 1 by 8 is the smallest one. Smaller, okay? Then, secondly, which is greater than this but smaller than the remaining one? Which is the second one we can take? Yes, this 2 by 8. Okay, see the shaded portion. Here, see this much part is shaded. Here, this much part is shaded. Here, this much. And here, this much. So, 2 by 8 will come afterwards. So, see, 1 by 8 is less than 2 by 8. 2 by 8 is less than 3 by 8, right? And 3 by 8 is less than 5 by 8. That means what? 5 by 8 is greater than 3 by 8, 3 by 8 is greater than 2 by 8, and 2 by 8 is greater than 1 by 8. Okay? So this is the comparison of the fractions having same denominator. 1 by 8, then 2 by 8, 3 by 8, and 5 by 8. So now if you see the, if you want to make a generalization, general rule, what we can do it, how we can do it, see. Denominators are same. Then see, if you observe the numerator, numerators are also arranged in smaller to bigger order. Denominators are same and numerators are arranged into this way. 1, 2, 3, 5. Means smaller to bigger. As we, if you take only 1, 2, 3, only 3, 2, 5 and 1. In this, which is smaller? 1, right? Then 2. Then 3 and 5. How we arrange the numbers? In that way only numerators are arranged, if you will see here. Okay, means what? 1 is smallest, so it is first, then after that there is 2, then 3, then 5. 5 is the greatest among these 4. Okay, so when denominators are same, it's very easy to compare. When denominators are same, just arrange the numerators into ascending order. Denominator keep as it is, 8 will keep as it is, and numerators arrange into ascending order. Okay, so when denominators are same, the fraction with smallest numerator is smallest fraction. Okay, so here see, in 1 by 8 denominators are same, 8, 8, 8, 8. Now 1 by 8 fraction with smallest numerator, that is smallest numerator is 1 here. So this is the smallest fraction, so it has come first. Okay, when denominators are same, fraction with smallest numerator is the smallest fraction.
You can write here when denominators are same, the fraction with smallest numerator is smallest fraction. Okay,
means this is as usual how we compare the normal numbers. It is same like this. Even denominators are same. Where the fraction is smallest numerator is the smallest fraction. With greatest numerator is greatest fraction. Okay, if there are only two, 2 by 8 and 5 by 8. The denominators are same, then fraction with smallest numerator is smallest and fraction with greatest numerator is greatest. Okay, so this is greater. 5 by 8 is greater than 2 by 8 or 2 by 8 is smaller than 5 by 8. We can compare it easily, very easily. Okay, but these, when numerators are same, this is the exactly opposite of this condition. How to compare the fractions when its numerator, when their numerators are same, denominators are not same, numerators are same. So see, in this condition, how the figure representation will be there. See here, there is one chocolate, suppose. Comparison of fraction when numerators are same, pay attention here. There is one chocolate, it is, first chocolate is divided into 2 parts. The chocolate is divided into only 2 parts, okay? And out of 2 parts, 1 part is shaded. Out of 2 parts, 1 part is shaded. So the fraction for this shaded part is total 2 equal parts, out of 2, 1 is shaded. Okay. There is one more same chocolate, 65 rupees Cadbury chocolate. Okay, same. But this time the chocolate is divided into 4 equal parts. How many equal parts? 4 equal parts, and out of 4 equal parts, 1 part is shaded. So the fraction for this shaded part is 1 by 4, 1 out of 4, okay? 1 out of 4, because 4 equal parts, so the 4 is written below the, in the denominator, and 1 is shaded, so 1 is written in the numerator, okay? Then again there is one, same chocolate is there. This time it is divided into 8 equal parts, and out of 8, 1 is shaded. So, out of 8, 1 is shaded, 1 by 8. Okay? One more chocolate we will take. This time the chocolate is divided into 16 equal parts. How many? 16 equal parts, and out of 16 equal parts, one part is shaded. So the fraction for the shaded part is 16 upon 1. Okay. Now we have these 4 fractions: 1 by 2, 1 by 4, 1 by 8, 1 by 16. 1 by 2, 1 by 4, 1 by 8, 1 by 16. Can you guess now which fraction is smallest and which fraction is greatest? Out of these 4, which fraction is smallest and which fraction is greatest? Can you guess? Which 1 by 2 is smallest? Yes? Or 1 by 16 is smallest?
Yes,
1 by 16 is smallest. Because if you see the shaded portion, all four chocolates are same. Okay? Just the parts are different. First chocolate is divided into two equal parts. Out of two equal parts, one part is shaded. Okay? So it is divided into only two equal parts. So each of two parts are bigger, right? And second chocolate, if you see, it is divided into four equal parts. So each part is smaller than this part, right? Compared to this, third one chocolate is divided into eight equal parts, and each part is smaller than them. Each part in the previous chocolate. Out of eight, here one is shaded. So if you see the shaded part, it is smaller than this one part in the second chocolate, right? And in fourth chocolate, the chocolate is divided into 16 equal parts, or 16 equal parts. So each part is very small, and out of 16, one part is shaded. So obviously it is smaller than this part, right?
Yes.
So if you see here, where numerators are same, see numerators are same, 1, 1, 1, 1. Only the denominators are different. Total equal parts are different. So in that case, when the numerators are same, fraction with greatest denominator is smallest fraction. If you see here, there are 16 parts. Out of 16, one is shaded. But if you see 16, the chocolate is divided into 16 parts, so each part is smaller, thin. Okay, so out of 16, when one is shaded, and if it is compared with this 1 by 2, obviously 1 by 16 is smallest. Okay, 1 by 16 is smallest because see shaded portion. If you see that these figures, four chocolates and the shaded parts, you will come to know easily which part is which fraction is smallest. This is smallest, right? So when numerators are same, fraction with greatest denominator is smallest fraction. 1 by 16 is smaller than. Secondly, which will come? 1 by 8 is smaller than 1 by 4. And the greatest fraction among these 4, greatest fraction among these 4 is nothing but 1 by 2. Okay? 1 by 2 is greatest. 1 by 2 is greater than 1 by 4. 1 by 4 is greater than 1 by 8. 1 by 8 is greater than 1 by 16. Understood? So when numerators are same, fraction with greatest denominator. Fraction with greatest denominator, fraction with greatest denominator is the smallest fraction. In this case, when numerators are same, 1 by 2, 1 by 4, 1 by 8, 1 by 16, so in these, fraction with greatest denominator, that is 1 by 16, is smallest, and 1 by 2 is greatest actually. Okay, and why it is so, that this will explain you. The figure of chocolate we have drawn here, that the figures will explain you why it is so. Understood? So means what, then 1 by 2 is there and 1 by 8 is there. Here numerators are same. One part out of two equal parts and one part out of eight equal parts. When both the chocolates are same, and first chocolate is divided into two equal parts, second chocolate is divided into eight equal parts. So one part out of two and one part out of eight. Obviously, which part will be greater? This. Which fraction will be greater? One out of two will be greater.
Okay, so think over it. Observe the figures. Why this when denominators are same, the fraction with smallest numerator is smallest fraction. Okay, and when numerators are same, opposite of that, fraction with greatest denominator is actually smallest fraction. Okay, so in this way we have to do the comparison of fraction when denominators are same and when numerators are same. There is third type of comparison, that is both are different. When numerators and denominators both are different, that is in this way, 4 by 5, 3 by 2, that we will learn afterwards. Now today only these two comparisons we have learned. Okay, watch this video very carefully. This write in your notebook. Draw this figure in your notebook. All these four chocolates should be same. Okay, here also all four chocolates should be same, equal. Understood? Observe it very carefully. Understand the concept. Write in your notebook. And then what you have to do? You have to solve. Practice 5.3, which is based on this. Today you solve half of it and tomorrow half of it. Okay. Means half practice 5.3, half solved today and remaining tomorrow. Okay, so thank you and have a nice day.